The Sport Park, and to call all the action, here is Clint Brown.
It is a 10-lapper here for the next end time as the racing series in the sunshine. Waiting for those red lights to go out. Revs up, and we'll be racing with the reverse grid showdown for the next end time as the racing series. So there's going to be a few nervous guys in the front row of the grid that perhaps haven't had a chance to get their pole position. All like Ken Thompson, Steve Vistonich, Stephen Spear, and 1, 2, 3 wide as they burst down towards the bus stop for the first time. Good start, Toby.
Yeah, sure to put on some excitement in the reverse grid format. Reverse top 10 it is, actually. So, yeah, certainly closes up the drivers, and you'll see some awesome passing manoeuvres as some of those guys from the front of the field yesterday make their way forward.
Great shot as they sweep around the southern loop for the first time, coming out of the shadows.
Matt Dodd looks like he's got a good run here. He might be having a look up the inside.
So we're talking about some of the South Island drivers here. Number 15, Matt Dodd. And 88, Steve Brown. Then there's Dallin Price, another one of the South Islanders, number 12. So watch out for them.
Yep, he's sitting in second and third there at the moment with what looks to be, is that Simon Baker making a move up the inside nice and cleanly.
Round the carousel into the sting. Then they'll head back down to the other side of the forest. Great shots here. Beautiful start to the race day Sunday at Highlands Motorsport Park. And the Speedworks Motorsport New Zealand Championship with the RX-8s. Remember, one of the big changes for this particular season is the new diff. And what's been the reaction so far?
Come
and spinner,
Dallin Price.
Whoa, he's just gone completely wide.
That's a fast section of track to be having a moment like that. Be interesting to see how that one panned out.
And let's hope he can get it started again. Number 12, one of the South Island racers. We're just pumping them up, and the rest of the field coming up and over the bridge. Simon Baker sticks it down the inside. He's the defending champion, of course, getting around the inside move and working his way back up from that reverse top 10 part of the grid. 98, Leo Bolt having a look down around reverse Indy. And suddenly Matt Dodd has been swamped by all the faster guys as they work their way and wiggle their way up back through the field.
Yep, and putting on some action nice and early in this race. They'll be wanting to make their way to the front as soon as they can and settle into a rhythm there before too much gaps put on. But Steve Brown now under pressure from Simon Baker going into the bus stop.
Great part of the track here, and it's very important to get that smooth line as they can glide and slide over the ripples, and they'll sweep around the southern loop, which was seen of a big crash yesterday afternoon, about 3-car pile up in the Oscar Super Saloons, but smooth and fast at the moment with the Mighty Masters. Although Simon Baker really having a good look down through the S's. And Steve Brown, I think, did the right thing by just moving over and said, okay, mate, we'll give you some racing room.
Pretty aggressive start there, Simon Baker. And, yeah, he'll look to make good gains at the moment with the rest of his close competitors behind him still seeking those final passes to get back to where they were in their race order yesterday.
159.1, Simon Baker. He's the quickest out there. He's been shadowed by 98, Leo Bolt out of Auckland, a 159.4. So the limited slip diff, the two-way slip, and here comes young Benny Stewart, number 33.
Nice, dominant pass there.
Out of nowhere, this is the 16-year-old kid that did 600 laps with the simulator to get himself dialed up and hooked up. But also, his dad was saying, he's been very, very successful in karting.
Yeah, and as you can see, that obviously translates to the racecraft that you're seeing there. We're obviously passing manoeuvres coming into play. And, very clean move that he's pulled off there. So, yeah, his karting background certainly aiding that.
And, of course, the karting is where so many young kids actually start their motor racing. You've got the go-karts down here at Highlands Motorsport Park, and then they can do some speedway right here at Cromwell, and then, of course, they get into tin tops like the Mazdas or the Toyota 86. We'll have a lot of more karting kids and champions coming out of karts, getting into the car, so there's that natural progression and pathway for New Zealand motorsport, which is really cool.
Absolutely, yep. It's young and old out there. Anyone and everyone, you've got a good mixture of very seasoned veterans out there who come from successful motorsport backgrounds, now enjoying the one-mate racing that next entire Mazda Racing Series puts on. And as you say, obviously karting, even 2K Cup progression out there. So you're certainly seeing the grassroots forms of motorsport and translating into this hot contested class at the moment.
And a very good reaction too to the next entire, which seems to go last longer and give you good grip as well, so great value for money and being a good performer in all sorts of conditions.
Indeed it is, so a semi-slick tyre, nice and diverse, so they can run them wet, dry, whatever it may be, and not as serious as a slick to activate, and obviously nice and cost effective for the class to run as well, so they hold their own for the whole durability of the race, so a credit to the Nexen tyre.
Comes out of South Korea, a massive tyre out of Asia. And once again, Ben Stewart out of nowhere, and he's down through the hairpin, whips up inside of Simon Baker and grabs the lead.
Well, we might be looking to have a not let that one up too easily as they come into the chicane here prior to the bridge.
What was the reaction yesterday? Because he spanked them by about 9 seconds, didn't he?
Oh, hey, he's just so cool, calm and collected, eh? What, it just, for him, he got in the groove and didn't, you know, be too aggressive out there, just drove it nice and cleanly, and look what showed, a 10-second gap crossing the finish line.
Two teammates in these beautiful presented black and yellow RX-8s, the Cello car and then the Paniki company. You've got to remember, he's only 16 years old and basically first time at this track, and here he is mixing it and passing the current defending champion, Simon Baker.
Yeah, I believe Simon's been a bit of a mentor to him jumping into this class. So, obviously a bit of experience passing on there as we've got one on the grass making a move up to the bus stop.
Matty Horn coming under pressure. Was that Andrew Jackson, number 21?
Certainly is.
That was a big, bold move, just slipping it on the grass like a little trimming the lawnmower. But not, you only got too much grip on the old grass.
Well, yeah, kept it reasonably clean, so well done to him.
Fantastic shots from our team at Volt TV coming out of the forest. Isn't it such a picturesque part of the circuit here at Highlands Motorsport Park? Of course, Tony Quinn and the team taking different aspects of different parts of famous tracks around the globe. And then when they designed the track and built it, as Grant Aitken was telling us many years ago, they decided to have different features. So that's the beauty of this particular track. It's a very challenging track, hard to pass though. So you've got to pick your place to pass. And so far, Ben Stewart has been nailing it coming down into and around the hairpin.
Yeah, chatting to him prior to the race, he knew a couple of spots where he's obviously been following a lot of the motorsport that's been happening here this weekend, and so he seemed pretty confident he knew where he was going to make his moves and find his way back to the front of the field today, and as you've seen.
45, Matt Horn putting the squeeze on 21, Andrew Jackson, as they come out of the hairpin, back up to the straight, and then you've got to line up the entrance to the bridge. That's where it all went wrong yesterday for Shane Hodson in the Roden supercar, the Super GTs, Roden Cars Super GTs, and unfortunately went straight first, head first into the wall and ended up in hospital, but hopefully will be released with a lower back injury later today. So you want to be careful going into that entrance to the bridge. But this guy's far from careful. He's carefree out in front. Ben Stewart, 33, grabbed the lead after about, three laps? With the reverse top 10 and doing a great job. Been shadowed by Simon Baker, so if he's the mentor, he's done a good job.
Yeah, well, Simon having a bit of a moment through the bus stop there, gathers it up and he'll carry on.
So 0.6 of a second between Stewart and Baker. Further back down the field, we've got 67, Anthony Torque, and 23, Matt Carkeek, another one of the young father and son combos. I mean, Terry Carkeek, of course, for Motorsport New Zealand, so good that they're passing on their love of speed.
Absolutely. A good battle unfolding here between the two.
Coming down around the straight. And this, you can see, to get them lined up through the S's. And then they'll go back around under the bridge.
Great to see Dallin Price has rejoined and is racing again after that moment we saw at the first lap around the back of the track there. So he's obviously got out of the gravel and he's able to continue on racing. So pleased to know that there's not too much damage there.
Yes, I think he must have just regathered himself. Obviously just overcooked the braking, perhaps missed his braking spot, locked it up.
Could have even been prior to the braking zone, so we'll have to ask him the question after the race, what happened there, if there was any influence on that one from any other parties.
To get a helping hand. Great shot as they slide and glide over the ripples, and the great shot as they come over the bridge and then down around the lake, down towards turn 13, 14, which is reverse Indy, and then they line it back up again for that big sweeping main straight here at Highlands.
Ooh, and we've got contact. Matt Dodd's been spun. Oh, hopefully he can get it out of the gravel there. Was that Sam Dashfield that might have assisted that one?
Right in front of us here at the Pit Stop Cafe and into the wall.
Matt was truly holding his own there in fourth for the South Islanders.
So that's at the hairpin. So this is further back down the other. It's all happening here, I tell you what. We've got action at the reverse Indy and action down at the hairpin. So one of them's parked up in the kitty litter. And what's happened there? Because he's come out of the hairpin and he's gone straight across. Meanwhile, out in front, 33, unstoppable, unbeatable at the moment. The 16-year-old Smash Dash, and everyone else is crashing, but old Dash is just smashing away, isn't he? Doing a great job, very smooth and fast. And he's opened up a big lead. What's happened to Simon Baker?
Yeah, we did see that moment earlier, a lap or so ago, Simon Baker. So I'm sure if he's got some maybe handling issues there, as the gap seems to have extended quite a bit.
Well, it's out to 5.1 seconds. He was 0.6 seconds, so they were right beside each other, right behind each other. So Simon Baker's obviously got a bit of an issue as well. 98, Leo Bolt. Then it's Andrew Jackson, Matt Horn, Steve Brown. 61 is Carl Gaines, Matt Dodd, and 47 up against the wall and seems to be out of the harm's way at the moment. So might be just double yellows down by coming out of the hairpin as we continue to race. Lap 5 out of 10. Stewart, look at the lead up and over the bridge. He's like a lone ranger out there now.
Making it look easy, isn't he? Nice and smooth. Yeah, not. We haven't seen him come up stuck at any point. It's just looking very clean.
Oh, another drama there. Coming out of the hairpin.
The battle we were following earlier, Matt Carkey and Anthony Talks. So it looks like Matt Carkey's got by now. As it looks like the safety car's coming out.
Yes, the Toyota Gazoo Racing GR Yaris safety car. They'll try and unhinge number 47, or was it 67? 47, Phil Clamis, out of harm's way, down by the kitty litter coming out of the hairpin. And that'll give the field a chance to actually regroup, regather, and catch up to each other for a restart, and will take away that massive lead that young Ben Stewart had opened up. 8.9 seconds. Again.
Yeah, that's impressive. Still four laps remaining.
It's very impressive because this is a one-mate class and we've had some very good drivers like Keith Wilkinson came down here. Remember, this is the opening round of the Nationals and he dominated it. But for a young kid like this to come in and put a big spin on these guys is very, very impressive. So we'll just try and work out exactly what happened down at the hairpin. I wonder if that part of the track is a little bit slippy and greasy at this time of the morning. And there he goes, just completely missed his braking and slid straight out of the hairpin onto the kitty litter into the wall.
Yeah, that was quite high pace he was carrying into one of the slowest corners of the track. So unsure whether maybe there's been a bit of a mechanical leading up to that incident.
Phil Clemmer's number 47 parked it. So now the recovery crews from Highlands, always doing a fantastic job. Big thank you to all the volunteers once again. Come from all around the country to get their fix and help out with making sure we can go racing. So it's great, along with the staff from Highlands, of course, and also the Speedworks team. Number 15, Matt Dodd, under pressure. Ooh, 117.
So that was a replay of that incident from earlier. South Island campaigner there, Matt Dodd, who was looking to be holding his own, unfortunately taken out into the final corner.
Sam Dashfield just missing his breaking point and just sort of a bit of a T-bone into the side.
It's a bit of a shame for Matt.
So once again, the recovery tractor. Good to see they got the old roof on there because he's pretty hot out here. So here's a lot of drama around here by the hip. And look, there's...
Back to lap one incident there for Dallin Price, a high-speed part of the track to be finding the gravel and obviously doing its work to slow him up and keep him out of harm's way.
Did he get a helping hand? Don't think so. It looked like he just would have lost it going in a bit wide. perhaps?
Perhaps, yeah. There's obviously been a bit of racing here this weekend, so maybe if you're not on the racing line, might be getting a bit greasy out there, a bit of debris starting to build up. So obviously, first lap of the race, maybe going a couple of cars wide, could have come unstuck.
But you can understand some marbles later on. And these two guys having a crack at each other? 99? 47.
Yeah, so Arthur Spatz, hailing from Christchurch, I believe. So, yeah, looked like he might have been trying to make a move on the RX-8 in front there and perhaps giving him a wee bit of a rub.
You might be busy, Toby, getting some driver reaction after this particular race, because it started off as a belter and has ended up being quite a bit of drama. Look at this. These two guys having a bit of fun.
Ooh. You always sustained a bit of damage there as well, but... Hey, that's what the reverse grid offers, doesn't it? Really brings the field together and you know, offers great racing action for everyone watching.
We'll get some reaction from Greg Rust, who's catching up with the action along pit lane. How are you, Rusty?
Ellen Facebook page as well. We are in the Roden Cars garage. And I'll get my cameraman Joe to come in here and just showcase this car, which is being worked on at the moment, being prepared for Liam Lawson's arrival a little bit later today. The GT members here at Highlands Motorsport Park had a chance to meet and chat with him very exclusively last night. This kit, words really do not describe it. So yesterday, he cut one flying lap around here, and in that time, went in the order of 3 seconds under the lap record here at Highlands. Now today he'll get more laps than that, and we're expecting the number to go even lower than the 1:25 that he chalked up yesterday. So this is an incredible bit of kit. You'll enjoy the sound of it. We'll bring it to you as it happens. He had the chance to sign some autographs for the fans who are here today. And if you haven't seen some of the news on social media in recent time, he's been confirmed with Carlin for F2 this year. So working with Trevor Carlin and the crew who have such a great history in single-seater racing in Europe and beyond. So great opportunity for him there. Did a super job with the AlphaTauri team at the end of season Formula One test as well in the Middle East. They chalked up a huge amount of laps. Hopefully there's an opportunity for him to do more of that, to do perhaps some more practice sessions and simulator work throughout the year. So a young man with a very bright future. He will be right here today as a part of our massive coverage on the live stream of both Roden Cars Super GT NZ. Two races still to come there. And we've just in the last little while seen the 86s heading to the dummy grid area. So some of the bright young stars in New Zealand motorsport are in that field. We've got a number of carters that are making the step up this year. There are three female races, very well-credentialed female races in that field. And they're all trying to chase the vastly experienced Simon Evans, who's done some great things in saloon car racing in this country and abroad in recent times. He won here yesterday. Great job off the back of a superb qualifying effort, we should say. But Clint, as you know, the rules for race two changed the complexion of the grid a little bit, and the likes of John Penny and Ronan Murphy will be up front for the start of that one.
Yes, it's going to be a great battle between those teammates. Having a chat with them last night, they were looking forward to trying to work together, perhaps, and try and work their way from the front of the grid in the 86s, like we've done here with the mighty Mazdas. And the reverse grid race has turned on plenty of excitement. Still under safety car at the moment with the all the action. And will the safety car come in at the end of this lap? And will we be able to get a restart? 7 out of 10 laps so far. All bunched up, Toby. This is all the nerves part now. The chance to just cool, calm, be collected and regather and regain.
Yeah, looks like they're going to do another lap commuting behind the safety car there. So hopefully we can see this one unfold in race format. But at the moment, yeah, behind safety car.
So it looks like it's going to be time certain, and it'll finish under safety car. They'll get the checkered flag. So disappointment there for some of the drivers, but Ben Stewart makes it 2 out of 2, and he is on the way out of karts through the simulator and onto the track, the real deal.
30 seconds, brother. All we want is an update. How it is, how the car is, and all that sort of stuff. Right?
Yep, certainly, yeah, proving some dominance there. And, yeah, proves those early moves making his race pan out well for him.
So just confirming the result from race two in the next end time as the racing series. Two out of two for 33, Ben Stewart, the 16-year-old from Wellington. Good skills. Just up the Cuppity Coast is number 11, Simon Baker. So he gets up to second. And Leo Bolt, number 98, from Dark Horse Racing. He's a great character and a top driver. Will come home in third place to wrap up a place on the podium, followed by his good mate, Andrew Jackson. Matt Horn, Steve Brown, Gaines, Dodd, Carkeek, and Anthony Talk rounds out the top 10 for the next end time Mazda Racing Series. Set to go, race three, later on.